views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of this station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
To the Angels and Answers Psychic Radio Show with clairvoyants Artie Hoffman and Sky Siegel. Artie is renowned psychic medium, spiritual life coach, and entertaining motivational speaker. Sky's given talent of inner guidance gives her the ability to interpret feelings and images impressed upon her by the spirit world. Call now for answers from your guardian angels and loved ones at 800-930-2819. And now here are your hosts, Artie and Sky.
Hey, everybody. You're with Artie and Sky, you're with Angels and Answers, and we're here to give you another wonderful show, a two-hour show. And so how you doing, Sky?
I'm doing good, sweetie. How you doing?
I'm doing very well. I was in Atlantic City yesterday.
Yeah, how'd that work out?
It worked out pretty well.
I like your jacket.
Yeah, I got a new jacket from California. I really love it. It's my new look. Everyone, you got to check out my Facebook. I'm so proud of my new appearance. I went to this wonderful person. What do you got here?
That was a gift given to me for you.
Oh, okay. What was I talking about? So I went to California.
Your new look.
Yeah, so I went to California. I got this really, really cool looking brown jacket. It looks like a leather jacket, but it's a synthetic jacket.
I love it.
And the salesperson told me that I could get this wet and it's not going to affect it. And I don't even know the name of the kind. Okay. Hopefully I can figure out. This she says there's two synthetics.
Very nice. I love the material. It feels great. It almost feels like suede, like a leathery, like a very,
yes.
a very yes. light suede. Looks like leather.
So I went to,
I like the stitching.
Oh, cool. Yeah. It's very cool. Very sharp looking. You got to check out my Facebook because,
nice.
I'm wearing that new leather jacket. It's a cool look. And I got photographed by Paul Monty out of Bristol, Pennsylvania.
He's very good.
Phenomenal videographer and phenomenal photographer. And there's some other pictures that I'm very proud of that he took. And after we finished, he made me look so good. I said, well, I'm glad you're good with trick photography. I said, I'm really glad you're good with trick photography.
Who's that guy?
I like him. And I normally don't like myself in pictures.
I don't think anybody does.
But these he really did a hell of a great job. So thank you, Paul. And again, that's Paul Monty, M-O-T-E.
M-O-N-T-E.
M-O-N-T-E. You know, out of Bristol, Pennsylvania. So if anyone needs really good portraits or headshots, he's the guy. He's the guy. Go-to guy. And all. So let's see. I still feel very refreshed. I'm still riding on a high from California. That's really good.
That is good.
And you know, it was weird. I sent out. I got really nervous. I sent out two gift certificates. Well, actually three, to my niece and nephew in California while I was in California.
Yeah.
And it like didn't get to them for like over a week.
Wow.
And I thought that somebody stole. You know, like you know, because some. Sometimes you hear stories where people open up the envelope,
or sometimes
if it looks like a gift card envelope,
or sometimes it goes through their machine and it gets torn up.
Yeah,
you know that.
Yeah,
you kept the receipts, right?
Yeah, I kept, and I couldn't find the receipts, and I was looking nuts. So then my nephew, so I called up my nephew, says no, he didn't get them, and then later on that day, he says they finally came in. He says we got them, and then my niece, I checked up with my niece because I got you know like Toys R Us. Yeah, and Baby R Us because they just had
Baby Sky.
Yeah, Baby Sky for my nephew Brett.
Isn't
that was cool.
A beautiful name, guys.
So and then my niece and nephew with my niece Shara. She had two kids.
That's a pretty name.
Yeah. So I just wanted to make sure. I get nervous when I sent out gift certificates.
Yeah.
You know. So you got to get maybe insurance on the delivery if you're sending anything valuable.
Exactly.
You know? And then yesterday, last night, I went to Atlantic City, and the guy hit my number four times in a row, won over $1,000. Four times in a row.
You won $1,000?
It was up over $1,000. We gave some back, but we hit – boom, boom, boom. My first hits at the roulette wheel. Boom, 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 boom. And he hit my mother's birthday, like on the first one.
Oh, so
back
cool.
to back. And then he hit number one, and I played a bunch of numbers, and then I doubled up on number one, and he hit number one again. And it was just awesome. I was on a high, you know.
It must have been somebody had good energy.
Yeah, I was like all riled up. I was telling the guy who was spinning the ball, I said, "You're the best thing that ever happened since sliced bread." And he goes, "You hear that, everybody? I'm the best thing that happened since sliced bread." And you always got to tip the dealers and the
oh, absolutely. You know? They work very hard. They don't make a lot of money, folks. They really don't.
No, they make it on tips, right?
Tips, but they make like almost minimum wage. They don't make a lot of money.
Really?
Yes. Yes.
Shit out.
No, I mean that.
I can't imagine.
And they go to school to do that. I don't know if there's some croupier.
Yeah, there is. Yeah, there are. I know you have to go to classes
yes.
to be a dealer or a croupier. Croupier is the one who spins the ball.
Yes. And I think there's different levels of these dealers. Like if you're doing that really high class one, what do they call that one? Where all the milk.
Baccarat?
Yes. Baccarat. If you're a Baccarat dealer, I'm sure you're making more money and you're getting much better tips.
Yeah. Yeah. Much better. But I got news for you. A lot of people who make big bucks, they don't tip at all.
That's true.
Some of them don't tip at all or tip next to nothing. I mean, it's
you know what pitiful. It is? If they're superstitious, they'll tip. And I saw that so many times around the tables. If you're superstitious, you will tip. Because you're feeling like you're sharing it, so God's going to give you more.
You want to know something? I was having such a great time. I ended up staying longer in the evening, so I stayed in Atlantic City. I was going to stay at a friend's house.
Yeah.
And because I ended up being there so long, I ended up getting a hotel room at Bally's. Had a great time. And I just realized, talking about tip, here I am tipping the groupier who's giving me all this money. And I always, always tip the people who do the rooms, you know, yes. clean them. And I just, we're talking about tips, I forgot to tip them. So I feel bad.
Don't worry. Just give it to me and I'll make sure they get it.
Thank you. Thank you. Now I feel better.
Of course. I always make you feel better.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, very, very welcome. Elvis, welcome to the building.
No, I strongly believe in always taking care of people who take care of you.
Absolutely.
You should. Especially when, there you go. Hey, you take care of me, I'll take care of you. No, it's only right when somebody is giving their heart and soul to you and you know they're taking care of you.
And you
in
know
every
they're
which
not
way.
Making that much money, honestly.
You want to know something? I got to tell you a true story. One of my friends who is a dynamite, well, he's retired now, but going back literally 25, 30 years ago, my friend who is a professional builder, and he would go into these multi-million dollar rich homes, not home, but apartments, condos, whatever you want, a townhouse in Manhattan, the apartments, you know, wealthy.
Super?
No, he's not a super. He's a builder. And so he would renovate, you know, these doctors and lawyers and people who built, you know, who'll buy a building or buy an apartment.
Yeah, yeah.
And nice size apartment. And then my friend, they would hire my friend because he had a great reputation. And he would be the guy to go to and he would like redo their whole apartment or kitchen or whatever. So he ended up doing, what's his name? Sean Penn's place.
Get out of town.
Yeah. And Sean Penn said, he says, "I'm only going to hire you only if you don't tell anybody that you're doing work for me," because doesn't want anyone to give him scripts. Oh, you're doing work for him. He says, I don't want any of that.
Anonymity. So, he wants anonymity.
Yeah. So he just wanted his peace of mind. So, you know, he was cool with it. He says, no problem. And, he says every day when he went to work, he said he left him a six pack of beer.
Aww.
And he says that when the job was finished, he says, not only did he pay me what I was supposed to get paid, he gave me $1,000 tip.
Isn't that lovely?
Yeah.
Well, when you have Sean Penn's money, you can be very generous.
Yeah, Jennifer.
Jennifer. You can be very Jennifer. My lips are not working today.
Yeah. So, your lips are sealed.
So anyway, I think I give people credit for those who take care of other people that work as blue collar workers, because, you know, it's wonderful to have a college education, but some of us cannot afford or could never afford a college education. Okay. So of course we had to, in order to raise our families and in order to survive in this world, we had to take jobs that were a little bit under average pay. So anytime that you see somebody who's a hardworking person and, you know, they're providing a service, you should tip them. You should.
No, yeah, it's just showing a sign of appreciation.
Appreciation, not only that, you're realizing
when
that.
When you're showing somebody appreciation, they'll do, you know, above and beyond and stuff.
Absolutely.
Because you're feeding the human spirit, and it's just good nature.
And it feeds your own spirit, too.
When it comes to people who physically do work for me, when I say physically do work, I'm not just saying in the now. I'm also saying anyone, like if they were a carpenter or the electrician, or they're physically doing work.
Right.
You know, I personally have a problem with trying to cut somebody down with their price if they're a really good worker, if they have a reputation of being a really good worker. I mean, you want to price it out and to make sure you're not getting taken advantage of.
Yes.
But I believe when somebody puts in physical labor, and my brother has a habit of doing this, which I don't like, you know, he always tries to get somebody at like ridiculous low prices to do work around his house. For me personally, if somebody is a salesperson and they're making commissions, you know, whether they're making, you know, say $1,000 on a job, so you can cut them down to $700, you're just making a sale. But when you're putting in your physical labor, time, and effort,
yeah.
I, within myself, just I don't have it within me to try to bring somebody way down.
Right.
If you're giving them a lot of work, I think that's a little different because, yeah. You know, you're making it worth their while.
Well, you know something? I have to beg the difference to you.
All right, hold that thought because we have to go to a commercial break.
Right, after that, I'm going to be begging the difference.
Yeah, then she's going to be begging for you, folks, so hang tight.
Close your eyes, baby. Follow my heart.
Tune in to the Angels and Answers Psychic Radio Show with Clairvoyants Artie Hoffman and Sky Siegel every Thursday for a two-hour show, 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern Time on Transformation Talk Radio. Artie and Sky deliver spiritual and motivational messages with passion and a sense of humor. Call in 800-930-2819 for live and on-air readings. Visit ArtieHoffman.com and SkyOfAngels.com.
What if we really didn't have to die to go to heaven? Are you curious about the afterlife or rebirth? The highly anticipated new book from author Dr. Susan Allison, You Don't Have to Die to Go to Heaven, is available now. Find out how to find guidance and healing in the spirit realms. Order the book today and put it on your must-read list for 2016. Visit drsusanallison.com to learn more.
Sky Siegel co-hosts one of today's most popular psychic shows, Angels and Answers, with Artie Hoffman as she communicates healing messages from the spirit world. These messages can be astounding, enlightening, and life-changing. Born with the God-given talent of inner guidance and the amazing ability to heal, Sky has healed thousands of people. Schedule a reading with Sky now. Call 908-500-1474 and visit skyofangels.com.
Called the Oprah of radio by her listeners, award-winning host Dr. Pat Basile is blowing the doors off of traditional talk radio. Get ready for an energizing delivery and powerful interviews with leaders in the field of human potential. Dr. Pat's fresh, new perspective on living life full out has catapulted her show to the top of talk radio. Tune in and Dr. Pat will help you thrive instead of merely survive. Visit thedrpatshow.com. That's T-H-E-D-R-PatShow.com for listening times in your area.
Artie Hoffman is the hottest psychic with the warmest heart and the host of the hit show Angels and Answers. A renowned psychic, medium, spiritual life coach, and an entertaining motivational speaker, Artie has helped over 15,000 people with his amazing intuitive gifts, his passion, and his humor. Call 877-ANGEL-02 to schedule a personal reading or to have your own psychic Artie party. That's 877-ANGEL-02. And visit ArtieHoffman.com and Angels and Answers on Facebook.
Awaken to your radiant, authentic self. For over 15 years, Soul Purpose Advocate Nancy Monson has been focused on leading change in the lives of those looking to live their true purpose. She is devoted to supporting people in living a soul-directed life every day. Let Nancy help you overcome fear, worry, and doubt. Visit everydayspirituality.com to learn how Nancy can be your Soul Purpose Advocate.
See you, Lord, but it takes so long, my Lord.
that this song was as long as it was. All right, welcome back, everybody.
That's a great song.
I love that song by the Beatles. You gotta love the Beatles.
That's George Harrison.
George Harrison, yeah. He's got a lot of great songs. If you were to listen to George Harrison's greatest hits, you're going to be very impressed on all the songs that he wrote, that sings. It's amazing. And he also wrote the song for, Ringo Starr. Nothing pays the dues when you want to sing the blues, and you know it don't come easy. Yeah, George Harrison wrote that for Ringo Starr. Yeah.
Well, first of all, guys, I'd like to give you all out there our telephone number so that if you'd like to get a mini reading from Artie or I or both of us, you can, and it's free, and maybe we can help you out a little bit. The number is 800-930-2819. That's 800-930-2819. Now, if you'd like a nice private reading with Artie, his number is 877-ANGEL-02. And he will give you a great reading, and you should look up his Facebook, and you should look up his webpage. He does parties. He's terrific. And if you'd like a reading with little old me, the number is 908-500-1474. And also, I get right to the spirits who you wish to speak with. And I also do parties, so you won't be disappointed.
We do funerals, weddings, and bar mitzvahs.
Yeah. And we also do communions.
And communions, and we're great on cruises, and especially brisks. And
Lipton everything. Tea.
There you go.
Now, what was I going to say? I beg to differ. What were we talking about? Oh, I remember. Artie had mentioned that.
Oh, about
about handling with people. About
handling.
No, it's called handling.
Handling?
Yes.
I never drove a Honda before.
No. I am surprised you're Jewish and you don't know that terminology. Anyway. You know, sometimes when people see you driving an expensive car and you're going into a, not dealership, but you're going into a regular mechanic, they charge you more. And I'll tell you how I know this. And also, when they come to your house and they see that you have a nicer house, they will take advantage and they will charge you more. I have had people come to my home and charge me twice as much as they charge somebody else.
Now, that's why I said when you find out what the going rate is, there are people who, when you have the going rate, and then they try to get them down from the going rate. That's why I said price around.
Yes.
Find out, you know, what the going rate is. You know, because also, not just because you have a beautiful home, but also, you know, you're out in the middle of farm country.
Yes, I understand that. But the problem is when they see my car or they see, you know what we did one time? We had, when we first moved into the house, we had a lot of fireplaces. So what we did was my husband decided to get skids. Those are those wooden pallets that they put bricks on. So we had gone to a company who had these skids. They were throwing them away. So my husband went in. And he was with the Toyota, or he was with the truck. And he says, you know, I'd like to pick up some of your skids. He says, come back tomorrow, and I'll let you know.
Wait, what's a skid?
I just told you. A skid is like a wooden pallet that
Those wooden pallets. All right, yes, I know what you're talking about now.
So he said to my husband, come back tomorrow, and I'll let you know if you could have them. Well, he came back the next day with the Mercedes, and he said, well, I can't really charge you nothing. I got to charge you $10 each for them. And he would have never said that had he not been driving a big Mercedes, not a small one, the big one. So, you know, I know that for a fact, because then I went there with the small car. I forgot which one it is. I think it was a Toyota.
Wait. What I'm talking about is people who do labor work.
Yes.
For you at your house.
I get that.
So put it this way. What I'm saying is, so you have, like, give you an example with the guy who cuts your lawn.
Yes.
All right. So you have a guy say, all right, now granted, he has acres and acres of property and he charges dirt cheap.
Yes.
So what I'm saying is, like, if he was to, like, the normal price for a price like for say a lawn your size, which is ginormous. I have no clue what it was. It like 150 is the norm for this
probably
size. Well, 150, 200.
Probably.
I mean, it's that much property. And so it's like, now on the type of person, I'll give you an example. You know, I can't imagine, like, between the gas and the amount of time it takes to do it and using his lawnmower, having to sharpen the blade. I mean, I take everything into account when somebody's in business. And so people have to make, you know, some money and make a living. And so the problem is you don't want to devalue yourself. And a couple of people in the recent tried to devalue my prices for what I do. And I stand true to myself. And because you're putting the energy out there to the universe that if you allow the public to cut you down or you're afraid to charge for what it is that you do, then you want to know something, your value is going to end up going less and less.
Exactly.
And you have to be able to stand true to your convictions that when you know you're doing a good job, when you know you're giving good value to somebody, who's and they're really benefiting from your services, it's very important that you keep your standards.
That's right.
And there is a difference when somebody is really sucking wind and, you know, and they really don't have a pot to piss in and they're really struggling. It's okay every now and again to give throw somebody a bone. But what happens if you give somebody a really low price on right. something that you know is worth a lot more, they tell their friends, they tell their relatives, and then before you know it, trying to get your regular price is going to be very difficult.
Well, I'll tell you something about my lawn guy.
Right after our break. All right. Right after our break, because
okay.
it's going to be a story.
Okay.
All right. So remember the lawn guy.
Okay.
All right. So stick around, everybody, because Sky and I, we're going to be right back right after this commercial break.
Psychic radio show with clairvoyants Artie Hoffman and Sky Siegel every Thursday for a two-hour show, 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern Time on Transformation Talk Radio. Artie and Sky deliver spiritual and motivational messages with passion and a sense of humor. Call in 800-930-2819 for live and on-air readings. Visit ArtieHoffman.com and SkyOfAngels.com.
We really didn't have to die to go to heaven. Are you curious about the afterlife or rebirth? The highly anticipated new book from author Dr. Susan Allison, You Don't Have to Die to Go to Heaven, is available now. Find out how to find guidance and healing in the spirit realms. Order the book today and put it on your must-read list for 2016. Visit drsusanallison.com to learn more.
Sky Siegel co-hosts one of today's most popular psychic shows, Angels and Answers, with Artie Hoffman as she communicates healing messages from the spirit world. These messages can be astounding, enlightening, and life-changing. Born with the God-given talent of inner guidance and the amazing ability to heal, Sky has healed thousands of people. Schedule a reading with Sky now. Call 908-500-1474 and visit skyofangels.com.
Called the Oprah of Radio by her listeners. Award-winning host Dr. Pat Basile is blowing the doors off of traditional talk radio. Get ready for an energizing delivery and powerful interviews with leaders in the field of human potential. Dr. Pat's fresh, new perspective on living life full out has catapulted her show to the top of talk radio. Tune in and Dr. Pat will help you thrive instead of merely survive. Visit thedrpatshow.com. That's thedrpatshow.com for listening times in your area.
Artie Hoffman is the hottest psychic with the warmest heart and the host of the hit show Angels and Answers. A renowned psychic, medium, spiritual life coach, and an entertaining motivational speaker, Artie has helped over 15,000 people with his amazing intuitive gifts, his passion, and his humor. Call 877-ANGEL-02 to schedule a personal reading or to have your own psychic Artie party. That's 877-ANGEL-02. And visit ArtieHoffman.com and Angels and Answers on Facebook.
Awaken to your radiant, authentic self. For over 15 years, Soul Purpose Advocate Nancy Monson has been focused on leading change in the lives of those looking to live their true purpose. She is devoted to supporting people and living a soul-directed life every day. Let Nancy help you overcome fear, worry, and doubt. Visit everydayspirituality.com to learn how Nancy can be your Soul Purpose Advocate.
Welcome back to Angels and Answers with Artie Hoffman and Sky Siegel. And I know that we do have a very patient girl from Middletown, New Jersey. Her name is Terry, and she's been waiting very patiently. Terry, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Okay, great. Thank you very much for waiting, being very patient. I just want to say one thing before we start this reading. My lawn guy may be reasonable per week, but he cuts my lawn like every week. And in the hot, hot, hot summer, he does it every 2 weeks. So what he's not making up in, you know, the initial, he does it frequently. My other guy only did it once every 3 weeks, and he charged me $125. Yeah.
Once every 3 weeks?
Yes. Except for the time of the spring when it grew.
Well, when you do it that often also, it's easier to do.
Yes.
And all. But still, right. That's...
And you know what? He's a little sloppy. He doesn't get all the weed whacking that I'd like to have done, he doesn't do.
For that price, darling.
Yeah, I know.
You have
still,
no right to
you
complain.
You know me. I like perfect.
So you know what? If you want perfect, you pay a little bit more.
I'm
say,
willing.
Listen,
okay.
You
willing.
Talk to him.
I'm willing.
That's what I'm talking about. All right, go ahead.
All right, so how you doing, Tara?
I am doing great, thank you.
What's the word in the hood, Tara?
You know something? You know something? I see a triangle around you. Why is that? Are you having problems with two people?
Not me personally, but my son and his girlfriend are having a lot of problems. I mean, I'm always in the middle.
Oh, well, there you go. That's
well, there's
a triangle.
The three. You're in the middle and there's three people.
Yes, I see that. I see that.
Yeah.
It's like poop will get off the pot. Do you know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
And if I were you, I would stay out of it.
They have to figure it out themselves, and they have a lot of trust issues within themselves.
Yeah.
It's just called maturity and growing pains, and that's that. It's as simple as that.
I mean, they might have a lot together, They might have a lot invested in each other. However, that could only go so far. And that can only go for so long. Are they thinking of making the commitment to marry? I think that would be a terrible idea. If they can't,
They're living together. You think it'd be a terrible idea or a good
idea? They're living together and they can't get along, God forbid marriage, and then 6 months later a divorce. You know what I mean?
You're going to be getting something in the mail that is going to bring you extra money, or you're going to be getting more money than you realize. I don't know if this has to do with taxes or an inheritance or something, but I see you getting unexpected money coming to you in the mail.
You know something?
Ooh, I like that. Also,
I'm sorry. Go ahead, sweetheart.
No, she said she liked that.
Oh. I'm also seeing that your son is not taking the initiative to have enough courage to actually let his girlfriend that he's living with know exactly what's on his mind. And he's putting it in the back of his mind, and it's building. Do you know what? Does that sound familiar to you?
Yes. Yes. Oh, totally. Because she wants to get engaged really bad and putting it off. I think he's just nervous.
Yes. And I feel as though if he's a little bit more upfront and explains to her rather than tries to step over the issue, I think things might get a little easier for them. But, you know, that's good advice in any relationship. Don't put off something that's bothering you. You don't have to fight about it, but you should sit down and discuss it.
And when they want to come to you, you have to be able to say, you know what, this is your battle. It's not your position to try to play mediator with them. Of all people, you know, you're the mother. So if anything, they need to see a counselor or somebody else who's, you know, it's not your position to do so. Also, there's a new dog coming, whether it be to them or to you, because I'm seeing a puppy, a little dog coming.
Oh, you see that for me, Marla.
Well, for her.
I'm going to tell you something. If you know, this is your son. So, you know, you're always going to be the mom of your son. So it's unfair to him to bring you these problems, because whose side are you going to take? You're not going to be objective. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
I don't care what mother it is. Not only you. You're not going to be objective. So, and, you know, if you give him the wrong advice, you're going to be the S-H-I-T heel. So you don't want that either.
But you want to know something? No. I've actually heard, and I've heard this plenty of times, where the parents would look at the other, not their own child, but look at the other child. I'm just saying. And they would say, what are you doing with my son? Or what are you doing? You are too good for him, or you are too good for her.
Too. Yes.
And in terms of the character and stuff.
But so I don't believe
the only reason why I said that is only because, you know, when you said that, you know, you're the mother and so you're going to favor your son and stuff, which could very well be. But at the same token, you want to know something? If they're going to get through this, they have to get through this together and without your assistance.
Right.
And your intentions are great.
Yes.
You know? But at the same token, you just bow out, and you'll see it'll work itself out.
They've got to fight their own battles. But I think in Terry's case, I think she's a little pro her son, which is okay, because I was pro my son too. I'm a mommy too. You know. But in her case, I think, like, you know,
you're going to see one of them giving each other. I'm telling you, I keep on seeing a little dog. So.
Okay. Yeah. I'm getting a little dog maybe too. Don't yell at me. Yes.
Jeez.
I guess we're going to master another one. They just had a litter there. Mommy and daddy's just had a little girl. Six girls were born.
Wow.
3, 4, 5 days ago. Wow. So the breeder calls me up, Sky. What? Six baby girls were born. I said, go away from me. You know I'm weak. You know what, honey? I think if you tell your son to just have a little courage and tell her what's on his mind, there's going to be a lot of harmony. The harmony will begin for them. And it's a good rule of thumb even to carry into their future lives together. Just say what's on your mind. You don't have to fight about it. Just say what's on your mind in a peaceful way. And that's going to bring them a lot of solace in the future as well. Then it's all about courage and harmony. So with that courage will come that harmony.
Beautiful.
All right. Don't, if you want to have, don't even get involved with it. You're going to have a lot more peace of mind, but yes. You're good. You're good.
And, good, sweetheart.
And unfortunately, we have to go to a break now. So it was a pleasure talking to you, and
so
thanks
much
for calling in.
It was a great pleasure speaking with you, Tara. Take care. And God
all right,
bless.
Sweetheart. All right, everybody, stick around because Sky and I, we're going to be right back right after this commercial break.
Into it for 2016. Do you want more prosperity, clarity, energy, and balance in your life? Join Lynn Brown now through March for one of her amazing workshops, each focusing on a key part of living your best life. For more information and to register for one of these amazing workshops, visit lynnbrownevent.com. That's lynnbrownevent.com. And get into it this 2016 with Lynn Brown.
Sky Siegel co-hosts one of today's most popular psychic shows, Angels and Answers, with Artie Hoffman as she communicates healing messages from the spirit world. These messages can be astounding, enlightening, and life-changing. Born with the God-given talent of inner guidance and the amazing ability to heal, Sky has healed thousands of people. Schedule a reading with Sky now. Call 908-500-1474 and visit skyofangels.com.
Tune in to The Jen Royster Show, intuitive guidance to inspire your life. Each Thursday at 8 a.m. Pacific and 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This amazing show is an inspirational hour that will take you on an epic metaphysical journey to discover the spiritual approach to life's greatest challenges. Dr. Jen is an internationally known intuitive counselor, spiritual teacher, and energy healer. Call in for intuitive readings and visit JenRoyster.com for more information.
Artie Hoffman is the hottest psychic with the warmest heart and the host of the hit show Angels and Answers. A renowned psychic, medium, spiritual life coach, and an entertaining motivational speaker, Artie has helped over 15,000 people with his amazing intuitive gifts, his passion, and his humor. Call 877-ANGEL-02 to schedule a personal reading or to have your own psychic Artie party. That's 877-ANGEL-02. And visit ArtieHoffman.com and Angels and Answers on Facebook.
Tune in to Sheer Alchemy with Leslie Fontaine on TransformationTalkRadio.com and get ready to stir up your passions, remove your blocks, and shift into an entirely new existence. Speaker, teacher, channel, clairvoyant, Leslie Fontaine is a transformation catalyst who channels a powerful energy from Source to catapult listeners into living the life they were born to live. Whether it's shifting from scarcity to abundance, from emotional pain into joy, or from illness into health, Leslie will help you step into the true essence and power of all that you are with the help of the Ascended Masters and Archangels. You will not be the same. Visit TransformationTalkRadio.com for show dates and times, and LeslieFontaine.com to say yes to explosive abundance.
Put us on this reservation. Took away our ways of life. The tomahawk and the bowie knife. Took away our native tongue. Their English to our young. And all the beads we made by hand.
try. So proud you live. So proud you die.
They took the whole Indian nation. Though I wear a shirt and tie, I'm still part red man deep inside. Cherokee people, Cherokee tribe, so proud you live. Maybe someday when they've learned, Cherokee Nation will return,
will return, will return, will return.
All right, welcome back, everybody. Now, today's topic that we should have talked about 45 minutes ago is about putting more energy into solutions rather than problems. And so many people waste their time and energy constantly repeating their problems over and over and over again. And there's somebody specifically, who I will not mention, that every single time she tells me her problems, I come up with the solutions. As soon as I come up with the solutions, she instantly tells me why she can't, or that, you know, she has all the, her ego is telling me why she can't correct the problem. And I keep on, you know, and it's my job. I just sit there and I listen and I instantly get messages, you know, of solutions. And it's,
maybe she just doesn't want to correct it.
Yeah, you know, well, she happens to play herself as a victim big time. And I have nothing but compassion for her, that her mindset is actually this way, you know. And it's a downer. It's a big downer for everyone who has to listen to this person or people constantly complain about how life sucks, how their partner sucks, how their children suck, how their job stinks, everything's, you know, about whatever, whatever. Well, then you need to put energy into the solution, whether you correct the problem or whether you work on the solution of getting out of the situation. But just to sit there and complain and complain and complain, you're not doing anybody, and especially yourself, any good just staying there.
Well, I have a friend, and this is a true story, who has problems with her husband. And she has sat down with me and her husband numerous amounts of times, and we have come up with solutions. And everything is great for a couple of days, and then he goes back to being his old normal self, even though she is trying to make a solution for the problem. So what do you do in a case like that?
Again, if the other person is not capable or willing to make the correction, because that's what's known as a narcissist.
Mm-hmm.
Someone who is just willing to be nice for the moment and then they go right back to their old ways.
Yes.
How many times are you going to get kicked in the gut or the face? I say that metaphorically. Maybe for some people it's not. And then still stay there and take it and take it and take it. You know who they are. You know what they're about. And it's your fault just as much as theirs for staying in a situation that you know is very toxic. You're waiting for changes and it's not healthy. Is there a lot of problem? Is there a lot of turmoil when you're going through transitions? Absolutely. But yet You need to invest more into the big picture so that you don't feel stuck. And you want to know something? I just moved out of a relationship, and you know, when things were not working out, I just chose to, you know, to move on, because the situations of everything going on, it's not resolvable. And when you're with somebody, you know, and there's times where people are really in love with each other, really care about each other, and they do see things from different points of view or different angles, although the bottom of the line that the love is there. But this is where compromise comes in. If you have one person who's willing to compromise and one other person who doesn't, well, that's a major problem, because it does take two to compromise, you know, to make it work. Just to have one trying and the other one doesn't, that's not a winning combination.
No.
So if you want to know what hell is all about, that would be you living in a living hell.
Mm-hmm.
That's exactly what hell is. When you're in emotional turmoil and feeling disgusted every single day, then you're living a living hell. It's not like you die and you go to hell. No, you're living a living hell.
That's so true.
Yeah. And so hell is an emotional experience, but there is a place called heaven. It is a true blue, beautiful, beautiful place from what I understood, from what I saw in the magazines and the brochures.
How about talking to spirit? Does spirit ever talk to you about heaven? They do to me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, absolutely. I'd love to hear stories of people who have, you know, clinically died. They met spirits on the other side and came back.
Yes.
And, you know, people do not. I have never heard one story where somebody said, I want to come back.
I know.
I never heard one story that once you have a taste of heaven, literally a slice of heaven on the other side, everybody, regardless of their circumstances here on earth, I have never heard one time where someone says, I got to get back. I got to get back.
Right.
You know,
right.
It's so beautiful.
Except it's amazing.
The only time where somebody is like devastated about being on the other side is if there's like a sudden death, and whether it be a car accident or a murder, and all of a sudden they're in shock. They go,
right.
Like, what the hell happened? Like, what?
Or you know? You're leaving behind children, very, very young children. And even then, you know, there's something in heaven where, as I've heard from spirit, that they make you realize this was for the better. And you do see that.
You see that and you understand your place.
Yes.
In the big picture.
And you don't feel badly.
Right. You don't. And you understand. But yet you have nothing but compassion for the people being left behind. Mm-hmm. And you understand that the people being left behind, it's all a part of their karma. You know, why they no longer have you, whether it be as the daughter or as the mother or as the father, you know, whoever your place is,
right.
You know, but this is all a part of everyone else's karma.
And that's when they send you healing.
Right.
And they so do that. They send you healing. Every one of your loved ones up there, when you are suffering here from a loss, send you tons and tons of healing. You have no idea.
Lots of love, lots of healing. And, you know, hopefully, you know, by having an open heart and having an understanding, you know, with God and life itself, you know, this is where you could start to heal. And it's about coming to an acceptance. It's hard to come to an acceptance when you're in that mourning stage because you're feeling such a loss.
Yeah.
But it's understandable. It's totally, totally understandable. So, but with that, everybody,
we need to take a break.
We got to take a break. And so this segment's finished, but hang on, because we still got another hour of Artie and Sky.
Yes,
so stick around, everybody. We'll be right back right after this commercial break.
You've been listening to Angels and Answers Psychic Radio Show with clairvoyants Artie Hoffman and Sky Siegel. Tune in every Thursday for this great two-hour show at 2 p.m. Pacific and 5 p.m. Eastern Time. And remember to call in at 800-930-2819 to get answers from your guardian angels and loved ones. Artie and Sky have helped thousands of people with remarkable accuracy as they tune in, use their intuitive gifts and inner guidance, and communicate with people's angels and loved ones who have passed.
Podcast On. To schedule your session, call Artie at 877-ANGEL-02 and visit ArtieHoffman.com, and call Sky at 908-500-1474 and visit SkyOfAngels.com for personal or group readings. And tune in next week for this fabulous hit show.